All right, thanks so much, Michelle. The debt debate in Washington shouldn't affect federal funds here in Missouri, and no air conditioning could have caused some heat deaths. KMUH's Lindsay Cooper's here to tell us about those stories and more as we look around the Show Me State. Hot is an understatement.
Yes, definitely is. Missouri officials say there shouldn't be immediate problems if debate about raising the federal borrowing limit causes a temporary halt to some of the state's federal payments. The state budget director says Missouri would have some cushion, but there may be problems later because the state can't fill in for the federal funds over the long term. Missouri's budget for the 2012 fiscal year is about $23 billion, including around $7 billion in federal money. Governor Nixon and state legislative leaders have been jockeying to put their mark on an overhaul of the state's tax incentives. Their proposal, targeted for a September special session, would create incentives for exporters at the St. Louis airport, science and technology companies, and computerized data centers, while scaling back some of Missouri's existing tax credits. Nixon has already called it the Made in Missouri Jobs Package. Economists remain skeptical about the impact of state tax breaks targeted for certain businesses. The KMMU fan club may have helped save some people's lives in mid-Missouri. At least 13 deaths in St. Louis this summer are suspected to be heat-related, as the temperature has reached or exceeded 100 degrees on 8 days. Many of the deaths have involved people who either didn't have air conditioners, didn't have the unit on, or didn't have a properly functioning air conditioner. In some cases, people on fixed incomes didn't use air conditioners because they can't pay the electric bills. But Missouri prohibits utilities from turning off electricity during periods of extreme heat.